I feel the pain in my bones. Like it is so deep, like you were not even there, and it's so tangible. You feel it.
Gabriella Foster grew up in Nashua, but fell in love with Israel while studying in college and decided to start her new life there as a citizen 4 years ago. Tonight, she describes the moment she heard of Saturday's attack on the country and its people while away on vacation.
He just starts telling us, like, they came by sea, they came by air, every direction. He starts saying numbers, and he said that 200 soldiers were killed. And in that moment, my heart completely sank, and I felt sick to my stomach, and I ran out of the synagogue. I couldn't hear anything more. So I've dealt with things like rockets, I've dealt with random stabbing attacks, but I've never dealt with the sheer number of people that have been affected.
Rabbi Peter Levy tells me there are people from his congregation in New Hampshire in Israel right now. He says their connection to one another is deep, and when he woke up to the news on Saturday, he was in pure disbelief.
A relative of a friend of ours, we've already gotten word that he was, as a reserve soldier, called up. He's dead. And that's in 36 hours.
He says people have been reaching out for guidance, looking to him for answers, but he tells me he's not able to think of any just yet.
I'm just trying to figure out what kind of words to put out to the congregation.
And Gabriella says even though she's not home right now, she stands strong with her community.
We're all hurting. Every single one of us is hurting. Doesn't matter if you're living in Israel or not.